Please join us in the final video of this demo series. In this video, we will demonstrate how to visualize data using Amazon Managed Grafana. Now we have deployed the station. They are all sending data and we stored it in the time stream database. Now, what needs to be done? AWS has this wonderful data visualization tool called Grafana. We use the Grafana tool to actually visualize the weather data that's sent from Joe's weather station in Tucson and Dan's weather station in San Francisco. Let me walk you through the process of adding the time stream database to Grafana, as well as like how to build a dashboard quickly. So as you can see on my screen, I need to go to the AWS icon here, click on data sources. And in the data sources itself, you can select from a range of different databases. I selected TimeStream. You can see that our data source is already there. Our TimeStream database is already there. It's that simple to add the data source from the TimeStream to Grafana. Now that we know how to add the data source, let's quickly go through how to build the dashboard. See the plus icon here, click create, and yes, this is the default panel that you can see here. Before jumping into that, let me tell you quickly that Grafana has a multitude of different widgets that you can play around with to add as many as panels or data visualization tools that you want. You can explore more on that in the AWS Grafana website. So click on add panel. So you see here that there is this graph that's like a default graph that's already been added. What you need to do is you have to select that data source here. In our case, it's the Amazon TimeStream database that we have selected from. Once you select it, it will automatically tell you the data, the database and everything. What you need to do, just like any other SQL database, you just have to add the query here, show the data. Now, in this case, I'm showing the wind speed here. I just copied it from my clipboard because I do not want to bore you guys with my slow typing. As you can see, the data is already plotted here. That's all it is. It's that simple to actually create a dashboard. You can add as many as different widgets you want to create a dashboard. So just walk you through two different items, how to create the dashboard, how to add the time stream data to Grafana. Now that we have gone through these two processes, let's move on to seeing the real data that Joe and Dan has been posting on. Moving on, let's go to the San Francisco data first, which is Dan's weather station. As you can see, this looks really pretty here, and you can see all the different data point sets that we have here. Wind speed, we also have this beautiful wind speed histogram. It gives you the current wind speed, gust speed, as well as the humidity factor. So whatever data we have collected from the weather station, you can see all those data in a very good visualization. This is for the San Francisco data, and let me show you the data from Joe's weather station in Tucson. The temperatures is really high compared to San Francisco. This is just walk you through the data from both the weather station. Just to recap, we started with our weather station sensors. We connected those through our host and connected that to the Expresslink module, send data into IoT core, set up a rule to extract that data and write it to the time stream. And now we have set up Grafana to read from that time stream. And so all of this data is live. What we can do with Grafana is a very impressive visualization. It's independent from the data collection itself. The thing to remember is when we publish to topics, it's going nowhere unless you take it and actually put it into a database. So that's why the time stream is a database that's indexed over time, and you write one line of code. These are real devices in the field, and we built it in less than 2 weeks rather than months. Thank you for joining Dan, Joe, and myself on the AWS Expresslink demo series. Have fun with AWS Expresslink IoT module and make some great projects.